Hello everyone, my name is Okoyemi Ojo. I'm the founder of Brunch and Bond, and today I'm here to sit and have a chit chat with one of our lovely members who is the boss of furniture in Nigeria. I'm not even saying Abuja. She's the boss. You just have to come check out what she's doing. But yeah, you get to meet her in a bit.
Ooh, yeah. Ah. I'm making my pimmy shade. All the girls calling me baby. See me see baby. Fine boy, wait, cause I be seeing baby. Tell me what you need again. I'ma forget, see back, babe. Me, I be complete package. Oh. I be fight for your love, but I know be beg for your love. I know be beg.
Beautiful Ife, the CEO of Royal Design Furniture. I mean, she's doing a great, fantastic job.
Thank
here.
You. Well thank done, you so sis. Much. Thank you, ma.
So, really, really, tell me a little about yourself.
Okay. My name is Ife. Mm-hmm. I'm a mother of two, a boy and a girl, 9 and 6. I'm married to Femi Fatoye, who is my backbone. So I used to work with a bank. When I left the bank, all along I've had the mind of doing my own thing, but I was looking at technology. I wanted to be a techpreneur.
Okay.
So when I left the banking, I got a job with a payment gateway company.
Okay.
Who was into processing of payment for online merchants, and also I was their chief marketing officer at that point. So that really gave me the real practical training of entrepreneurship, because I was also deputizing for the CEO. When he's not around, I'm in charge, and that really exposed me to the real field training of being an entrepreneur.
Okay.
I think that's where the fire started.
Because now it looks like you actually have ready to, you know, you can just order and take them out of the store.
Yes.
So how did you grow, like?
Okay, like I said, it started from people's request.
Okay.
So while I was still working with someone, I decided to, myself and my husband, mm-hmm. now made up our mind that maybe we'll be doing it on a part-time basis, because he is also working with a bank.
Okay.
So I now told him that let me see what I can do. So I got some artisans. So if we get requests like that,
mm-hmm.
I'll do it on a part-time basis, mm-hmm. then we'll deliver. So the request kept increasing and increasing and increasing. So, and as at that time, I don't even have a store. I don't have anything. It was just an online thing. So we now decided to get a place,
okay.
Like a small place. At least let people have a contact point where they can come to.
Mm.
So that's how we started. We started with a sofa. We decided to just produce. We didn't really have the fund then, so we produced just one sofa.
Mm-hmm.
Then I think after a month, we were able to do a bed.
Mm-hmm.
So we started with one bed, one sofa.
Mm-hmm.
So when they come, they see, okay, this is an, I will rush, I will have to book an appointment with them for break time.
Yeah.
So I will rush down to the store, show them what we have, that one bed and one sofa.
Yeah.
And from there, the requests kept coming,
okay.
The order kept coming, and I can't even believe where we are now.
So what would you say, like, is one of the things that, you know, helped your growth, like, in this business? You said, okay, you started with one sofa. How did you grow? Is it, what can you say is the tool that helped you grow the most?
I think it's criticism.
Okay.
Because before we had that store, we were still trying to raise money to start.
Mm-hmm.
I got a request from a particular lady that she wants to produce some furnitures. So I had to open up to her that I don't have a store yet, but don't worry, when you make payments, your sofa will be delivered.
Mm-hmm.
So she now said, no, I need to take her to the artisan that is doing her jobs.
Okay.
So I was confused, but I didn't have a choice than to just to gain her trust.
Mm-hmm.
I had to take her to where we produce. Unfortunately for me, or fortunately, I don't know, by the end of the day, it was a positive push that I needed. So she started telling me that she is not satisfied with what she saw and all that. So As she has not made any payments, I just decide to let her go. Mm-hmm. Shockingly, I just saw my name on Facebook as a scam. She started writing so many things that beware of this company, Royal Design Furniture, blah, blah, blah. They are scam. They are this. They don't even have a store. They don't even, in fact, they produce by the roadside. Different stuff. So I made that call, called her that, why did I take any money from you? Why are you calling me a scam? She said that it doesn't have to get to that stage before I'm a scam. I felt really bad. It broke me. I cried for days because I've never experienced something like that before. I didn't collect your money. I opened up to you my processes. I took you to where we are doing the raw state of the company. You saw it. So how dare you call me a scam?
You see, that's why some people package. Because sometimes when you just come raw, the way you are, some people might not appreciate it.
Yes.
That's why some people will now package.
I learned in the hard way. That was the push I needed. So I had to find a way to raise money by all means, rent a store, and start with what I can start with. So that was the break. You know, Social media really helped us. And referrals. Any client that comes in here, no matter the offer the person is giving me, as long as I don't have to compromise on my standard, even if it's 2 naira I'm making from that project, I'll take it and make sure I impress that particular client and be that particular client's friend. So we got a particular client then. She was an Ajia. Because of these things that I talked about, I saw her personality, the kind of standard in her house, and she came to us, this small company, to produce her furniture. So I made up my mind that I'm going to wow her. So we went out of our way to do that particular project. We didn't make anything from it at all, but I really want to make her happy. And she became
freelance.
All her family members, all. You even as long as your furniture is up to 2 years, you must change it. So I think what helped us is going not concentrating on profit from the beginning.
Being a mom and a wife are running this kind of business that seemingly looks like a man, you know, business. How do you cope? How do you balance it? And what's your typical day?
Okay, our resumption time is 8.
Okay.
But most of the time, my day starts from 6:30. From the house, because some clients, when they wake up, they remember something on their project, and you have to be there to attend to them because they've given you their money.
True.
Most of the time, my day starts from when I wake up, because a message might be waiting for me, or a missed call, or something that I need to attend to immediately. But the main call work starts from 8 to anytime.
Whenever.
But I've been able to manage both my home front and the job very well because I have good support system. I've
been able to go this far if I don't have a supportive partner.
Yeah.
Yes, I have a partner in the business.
Okay.
He's my husband.
Yeah.
He is now fully on board, 100%. He used to work as a part-time, but now the business has grown to where we need to create structures and things.
Yeah.
So is not fully on board. Without his support, I don't think, because sometimes I get hooked on financial aspects.
Yeah.
I'll need somebody to bail me out. It's always there.
Yes, I know how it is. So. Thank you, Daddy. Daddy, Royal Design Furniture.
So it's my support system and my staff. I have good staff. I always say it behind them, in front of them, that they have my heartbeat. Because sometimes things go wrong. As a woman, I get to get emotional and all. My staff will say, no, ma, hold yourself. Yeah. Hold yourself. We have to face it. There are designs that they will bring that will say, no, we can't achieve this. They will say, no, ma, let's study it. So without my staff, my husband, I don't think I can.
So, you know, in Nigeria, they say we do not produce anything because we import almost everything because we don't have maybe the raw materials that we need. So I'm wondering, how do you manufacture these things? Do you have to like import the raw materials or do you have them available in Nigeria?
Yes, we have the wood available in Nigeria. In fact, our wood are way more better than foreign woods. Yes, because a lot, some foreign furnitures that come in, they come in decayed. We will have to reconstruct for some people. So our wood is very good. Okay. But in terms of fabrics, accessories, they are all foreign materials. They are still available in the local market here in Nigeria, mm-hmm. but they are all imported materials. Okay. Yes.
You know, now that everyone is trying to be an entrepreneur, and there are people who obviously want to go into this kind of business, and with social media and everything, it seems like there are a lot of things you can do with little or no capital, especially when you have a phone. So can someone actually do this kind of business without capital?
Advice that they should partner with or collaborate with a furniture manufacturing company if they want to be going into bespoke.
Okay.
They can partner with companies that are producing,
like
get
yours.
Jobs, the hair, get jobs, give it to them to do.
Okay.
Then from there, you'll be learning and you can gradually grow your capital to have your own store
in the next 5 years. Where do we hope to see Royal Design Furniture? What are your hopes for the company?
Okay. To be the only option for bespoke furniture production. And we want to be able to compete very well with foreign furnitures.
Mm-hmm.
We want to help people to get luxury furniture without having to break the bank.
Yeah.
With little, you can get that high-end furniture that they import from abroad.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the mission of the company. That's what we are looking out to pursue in the next few years
it's
to come.
Awesome, you know, mm-hmm. just getting to know all of this, you know, and coming to see your beautiful store.
Thank you, ma.
Oh, you're doing a fantastic job.
Thank you, ma.
I can't wait to change the whole furniture of my house.
We are here to make that happen.
I can't wait because I'm even going to look around and just show everyone lovely things that you have.
Final notes.
Okay.
What do you do for fun?
I don't think I even have that life again.
Can you imagine?
It's so furniture, it's
work,
sleep, wake up. Even
Church.
While I'm sleeping, I'm thinking of the next design I need to crack.
I think I know what to do. One of these days, I'm coming to drag. Maybe one of these Sundays, we should take the kids out.
Yes.
Let's go. Maybe swim.
I need it. I need it. I've not, for 3 years now, I've not really been a social person.
Yeah, how long is the business?
It's going to 4 years.
Tell me what you need again. Mama forget, see bad way. Me I be complete package. Oh, me I be fight for your love. But I know fi beg for your love. I know fi beg for your love. I know fi beg for your love. Me I be fight for your love. But I know fi beg for your love. I know fi beg for your love. No, we yeah, baby. Baby, share me, be your ba, be your ba.
I want you to treat me like a king,
baby,
baby.
Baby, share me, be your ba,
yeah,
be your ba.
What do you need, baby? I get the sauce, get the juice, baby. I get the everything for you, baby.
As long as you dare.
Bad boy, why you not feel use play game?
Okay.
I be king, I be me, share. Girl, you know, so my love far away.
Far away.
Far away.
Me, I be fight for your love. But I know you beg for your love.